什么? Am I filming something?
The hell? What is this?
When you're ready, you just press play.
Okay, 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 wait, let me put some makeup on. The fuck is this? Oh my god. So, I got surprised by this. My team came and they're asking me to sit down here with all the lighting done. They were like secretly hiding in my room the whole time. I was like, why is that? Like, they are being so weird because I was in the living room. And apparently I have a video in front of me and it says, for Wendy's birthday, we gathered some of Wendy's friends to ask them questions about Wendy. So I'm a bit scared. I guess I'll go and play it. Right? Play ah.
How did you meet Wendy?
So I first met Wendy about 10 years ago. I was a blog reader first back then and I got picked for one of her blog adverts. Basically, it was an ad where she had to do a photo shoot with some of her followers and I got picked. And I remember, of course, feeling quite intimidated because, you know, like she was a big popular blogger and she does seem like she can be quite fierce.
I still remember, right, for that particular blog post, I had to pick like 5 followers of mine, like blog readers, like rather, to do a photo shoot together for a shampoo brand. I looked through the pictures of all the girls who applied and there were a lot of them. And I was like, wow, this one very chill. We must ask her to come to the set. Yeah, then the first time I saw Sophie, I was just like, oh, she's very pretty. I don't dare talk to her. But of course, now we're very close, so I don't care anymore.
We met at the Naf Neng Chinese New Year gathering and she was late, so she was placed next to me. So she started asking me about the food, the dinner. And yeah, I just found... I was initially really, really intimidated and scared of her because, you know, I really think she thought I was like a restaurant staff that was sitting in the tasting together. But she really treated me like a friend, I think, and that was very nice of her.
I cannot remember this thing, but I don't think I ever thought that Mong was a restaurant staff. The Naftan people did tell me that she's also a fellow like blogger lah.
I first met Wendy when we co-hosted a show called Girls Out Loud. This was a Channel 5 way before the time of YouTube.
Yeah, so like I know Ross also many years already because we were filming for Girls Out Loud together. Still friends now.
3 words to describe your first impression of Wendy. Loud. Not the most polite of person. Okay, that's already more than 3 words.
Funny, witty, and loyal.
Why so short?
Very, very short.
What the hell? Hey, seriously, everyone is talking about how short I am. It's not my fault that I'm short, okay? I just cannot grow any taller lah. My mother also same height, so...
Act out how Wendy would act when she's angry.
You siao ah?
Oi, you can you can smell it, you can. Why are you like this?
That's what she's like.
Right? Am I right?
You better don't drink, I know I cut off your penis tonight.
I always threaten Mike with cutting off his penis. That's accurate.
I'm not gonna swear.
Mong's just like, I'm not gonna swear. Okay, you wanna see how I'm like when I'm angry, right? It's just like a lot of vulgarities and just a lot of shouting. But if I do get so super angry, right, most of the time I'll just start crying, like tears of anger, and then I'll just exit out of the situation because I won't go and confront lah, I guess. Yeah.
What is something I can't trust Wendy on when she says it's good? I will not trust Wendy when she says this certain restaurant
food.
Is good. Okay, she sucks on food. Everything to her that is free and that has Wagyu is good.
Not true that everything is free, that I would think is good. There are many times I went tastings and it's terrible.
Actually, she's not picky about food. So I won't trust her on food.
Food, I guess.
Food. Yeah, I think like
everybody answer food, yeah. To me, the difference between me cooking a Maggi Mee at home, okay, and then egg la and all the other stuff that I like into the Maggi Mee, a curry Maggi Mee, okay, for example, versus like a $200 meal, it is not much difference.
How has the wedding evening then changed to the person she is now? Well, she's basically changed her face. She looks way better now and I think she can agree with me on this.
I discovered with some of the productions that she's done, right, that She's someone that is remarkably capable of responsibility, and that is something that I never knew of until at least the last 5 years. I think during one of the video productions that she was the scriptwriter, she woke up dutifully at 9 a.m. or something to do the wardrobe and all that, and that is something I have never seen before in my life.
The story that Iki is talking about, right, is because I did behind the scenes work for Girl Band called Girl Band for Click Network. I was the scriptwriter lah, so I just thought that after I'm done with script writing, right, I'll just go help out on set, right? Like, it's nothing, no big deal. I got arrowed to become the stylist and the producer. So I had a lot of responsibilities on my shoulder. Wow, it's damn troublesome. Then you have to remember, sometimes it's like, you know, one scene you film over 3 days, right? So you need to make sure that the actor is wearing the same clothes, the same accessories, the same hairstyle. Like, as in, we have hairstylists and makeup artists, but I have to instruct them on what to do to make sure everything is a cohesive project lah. And it was so much responsibility, and it's not one of those things where, you know, if I don't do it, somebody will pick up the slack. For that whole month when we were filming Girl Band called Girl Band, right, I was super responsible, which is something that shocked all my friends. I think during that time everyone was just like, who are you? Like, every single day I wake up at like 6 a.m. and I go to sleep at like 3 to make sure that, you know, all the clothes and everything are ready.
For the whole of her life, she doesn't drink alcohol, but recently she has picked up drinking.
Like, last time she's very against alcoholics or like alcohol, but slowly she'll be like, is it really that good? Let me try. I heard that she picked up drinking recently, so I haven't seen that side of her yet.
I also don't know what really happened, but recently I started like just taking very, very small sips at a time, and I realized that it's actually quite fun to get tipsy. Now that I am capable of drinking, right, I understand why people, when they are drunk, they always ask other people to drink. Because when you're around a sober person, when you're drunk, it's just not fun. And I realized that, 是我的错啦, all these years, I have been that judgy, sober person there.
What's a side of Wendy that people don't know?
A side to Wendy that most people don't know is that she cries. She feels.
Don't tell people, Ross.
And she's very sensitive.
One side of Wendy that people don't know for sure is that she's very, very soft-hearted inside.
I really don't care about what the public thinks of me. Like, you know, if you're just a random person, I don't care what you think. But I actually really care a lot about what my close friends, family, all these think of me. So if, like, let's say a friend is angry with me over something, right, then and the friend tells it to me, I'll be very affected, like, for many, many days. Yeah, so I think that people don't really see that side of me, which is very few privileged people can see it. Only if I really treasure you, then I'll be like that lah. If I don't treasure you, then you don't like me, then fuck you lah. You know what I mean?
She can be quite emotional lah. Like recently when she got cancelled, I think it really affected her because she got worried lah about, you know, her family and the people around her. So she's not actually, I mean, she's a tough cookie, yes, but she's still human lah at the end of the day.
Mm. The whole cancelling thing, right, it's not so much of, oh, it affected my career or whatnot, but it has affected some interpersonal relationships between me and my friends. And then also during that period, I felt like I could see very clearly like who my real friends are. When I'm powerful and I am like famous and I am like influential, right, everyone wants to be on my good side, right? They all think that there's some advantage to it. But when I'm down and everyone's talking shit about me and I am not popular anymore at that time, suddenly you see some people, they don't appear, right? So it's just like, I know who you are lah. You know what I mean?
What is something you admire about Wendy? Wendy is a very loyal friend. And I think you will get the same answer from a lot of her close friends.
Well, what I admire about Wendy is her loyalty to her friends. She's logical in many other aspects of life, right? When she articulates issues or topics. But when it comes to her friends, often she's fiercely loyal to them.
She's very genuine. She's a great friend. She's very loyal. And I mean, she's many qualities that you want a good friend to have, lah. Yeah.
She's a very loyal friend, and let's say if she has $10 in her wallet, if you're really in need, she might give you $7.50. She keep about $2.40 for Dash and keep $0.10 for herself and nothing for Mike.
nothing for Mike. So poor thing. Anyway, I just want to stress that if Ikin needed $10, I wouldn't give it to her because she's fucking rich. Huh? I know she bluffed me one.
Share a memorable incident you had with Wendy.
So we were going to Pulau Ubin with
her. Oh my god.
Many years ago, and we lied to her that Ubin need passport to go, and she legit brought her passport. She took it out and she asked, "Hey, where's the immigration?" So yes, that's Wendy for you.
This Pulau Ubin thing, really is still talking about it after it happened, like for like maybe 15 years ago, like so long ago. When you're 18 or 19, why would you know whether Pulau Ubin is in Singapore? Or I just really thought it's part of an Indonesian island, like Batam, like that. Like, I tell you, this Weili is the worst. Like, he always come out with this kind of stupid lies, right? That you don't know whether it's the truth or not the truth. Like that day, right, we were listening to the music in the car on the radio, right? And this really old song came out, which is a Pan Mei Chen song, okay? And like, okay, most of you would not know who this singer is, okay? It's a very, very old school singer. Anyway, so he just randomly said, right?
Oh, do you know, right, that Pan Mei Chen used to be a prostitute last time? That's why she hates men and became a lesbian, like she said it in like an interview or something.
Then we were just like, huh, really? Oh my god, I didn't know leh. She was a prostitute, wow, so jing bao, you know? Then I was just like, then after that, he was just like, I bluff you all. This kind of thing also want to bluff us, eh? Then bo liao, right? It's really not my fault, lor. Then like recently, right, like literally yesterday, we were on a yacht for my birthday party, and we had one of those candles that was shooting like sparks out, like a giant flame and a lot of sparkler, like kind of candle, right? He kept asking me to blow it because he said that the candle can blow out when you go and blow. Then I keep blowing it, and of course it keeps coming back, lah. Probably like some propane or whatever flame, right? Then I was just like, 我想了一下, 我觉得, 哎呀, 我又很笨, eh? 又 fall for 他的 trick again, eh? Like seriously, 很多次了, cannot deal with him. Cannot believe anything that he say one. Anyhow, go and tell me that Pan Mei Chen is a prostitute. What the fuck?
Her followers came to attack me online. So it was on daily, right? And then at a point in time, I was like trying to like do some weight loss or like, you know, workout thing. And then there was once I was like, oh my god, I have a bit of like baby abs. So I took a picture. Yeah, and then you could see a bit of my underboob lah. So she said like, oh, I thought that this blogger was so decent, but she's flashing her underboob. I'm not gonna follow her anymore, thanks. Something like that. And then after that, her followers came and then they called me, oh my god, you underbooked girl.
You know, I just want to specify that this is before the era of like Instagram where there are a lot of slutty girls online. So in the past, people were a lot more conservative. 你要拍你的 apps, 你就拍你的 apps. 你为什么要给 put 你的 side boob 在下面? Like, you know, I just feel like it was a bit 做作, you know what I mean? But now if she does it, I'll just be like,
wow, you know, that's very hot, yeah. You should ask people to look at your underboob.
Because that's the difference between friend and stranger.
We actually went to quite a few countries together for press trips. So we went to Korea, I think twice, or is it once? Went to Japan once. We even went to Prague. I think going to Prague together with her was one of the nicest memories we had because I really got to know her much better on that trip. So realized that she was such a real and down-to-earth person and that she was a good friend.
You know, I also miss traveling with her because she's really good, like, travel buddy.
What is one of Wendy's quirks? She forgets things very easily, so she can repeat the exact same thing twice within a few hours. Yeah, that's not really a quirk, it's kind of like a disease.
I mean, Mong said that my dementia is a disease. People will just say, oh, like, this event that you're going to later, this other influencer will be there. And then I'm thinking, like, did I talk shit about this person before, yeah? And then I cannot remember. I legit cannot remember. Then I go there, then the person tell me, then I'll just be like, maybe I did.
She freaking hate to wash her hair, lor.
Generally don't really like washing my hair that often because every time I wash it, right, the color just fades a little bit more. So like, as I wash, it just becomes more and more yellow, which is very annoying. So I wash once every like 4 days, sometimes 5.
So happy birthday, Wendy. I know you definitely wish to stay youthful looking, skinny and pretty forever. May all the shows you watch be unwork.
She knows that like every time like when I watch shows, right, like, and then there's some work element in it, I'll just be like, ugh. But I found a solution to that, which is to watch Chinese shows or any other Asian country shows, because only American shows are fucking woke. The rest of the shows, okay man.
Just want to wish you a happier 37th birthday.
Excuse me, Mong, why are you going to tell everybody my age? Okay, I am 21 years old. Yeah.
And thank you so much for, you know, just bringing so much joy, love and laughter to our lives. I know that we haven't been the closest or haven't been able to spend much time together lately, but I just want to let you know that I'll be there supporting you in my own ways. Love ya!
Happy 37th birthday, Wendy.
37.
I really, really appreciate you as a friend. Like, whenever I need help, you are always there for me and probably the only one who's awake till 7 a.m. that I can rely on. I hope that we can soon travel together because I know that's what you want, then we can go cheap shopping again.
I actually don't have much to wish you. Actually, I feel that you're somebody who is very content with life. A bit too content sometimes. Happy birthday!
Yay! Aww, so cute, Chewy. Ina mentioned that I'm very content with life, which is true, I guess. Like, people often see me on the internet as some kind of always angry, bashing people kind of person. I have very short fuse, but it also blows over very fast. So most of the time, I'm just doing my own thing, being happy, watching my shows, playing my games, or hanging out with friends, eating supper or whatever. And I don't have any drive to be more hardworking, earn more money or whatever. I don't ever go and dwell on unhappy things and get emotional over stuff. Most of the time, I'm just okay, content. That's why, yeah. So no work, I also okay one. Last time when I'm with Nafnang, right? I would get ads and then the money will go into the Nafnang account and then I have to physically click on something to say I want to withdraw the money. So what I do, right, is to just leave the money with Nafnang for as long as possible until my bank account becomes almost zero, then I'll go and withdraw again. Then I'll do the same thing over again. So every time the check that I get, right, is can be 60k at one time because I use finish, then I'm going to take the next one. And I will not go and count, right, this ad you got pay me or not, this ad you never pay me. You know that kind of thing. Sometimes I'm sure there's some accounting error, but I wouldn't know because I'm just 够钱用就好.
There are so many ups and downs in our friendship. A lot of blocks, deletes, unfriend, refriend.
Excuse me, I just want to say that I have never personally unfriended Ross or blocked her or unfollowed her. It's always just her, okay? And I just want to specify, it's not because I'm a terrible friend, but because Ross is just like that. She's very anal about who she keeps in her circle. And sometimes it's you rub her the wrong way, right? She's just I'm going to unfollow you and stuff. So it's just, that's just her, okay?
You're definitely someone that I'm so glad that I fought to keep, fought to understand, and fought to love. You're worth every single, amount of effort,
time,
and heart. I love you two bits, and happy birthday.
When it comes to being a loyal friend, right, I feel I really, really see it in Ross, because she is fiercely protective of everyone that is in her inner circle, and I am very honored that I'm one of those people. Just with her food, she's very, very nitpicky about who she remains friends with.
Stay happy, and if you're happy, every day is your birthday. Anyway, with friends like us, every day is a birthday. So yes, happy birthday. Okay.
It's true. With friends like Weili, every day is my birthday. He is not that kind of person who would say mushy stuff ever. So that's why in this video he's not doing it either. So I'm not gonna do it either. But we both know, Chu Hao.
I just want to say that Wendy, you're getting old. You're as ancient as I am, so time to act your age like an auntie.
I will not act my age, okay? I'm a child at heart, I'm a teenager at heart. Ming's birthday is 2 days before mine. He's so much better at being an adult, you get what I mean? He still is very childish in certain ways. He likes to collect toys and all that shit, right? You can see there in the screen that he's always about all these cutesy shit. He loves to tell me to take on more responsibility at my age and stuff. Because we're both fellow Taurus people, so we have some certain same traits. We're both obstinate, loyal. He is super in love with being a leader and being an adult, whereas I'm just I don't want any responsibility, don't give me.
I wish that for your birthday this year, may you not be cancelled for the next 10 years.
Okay, so I finished watching the video and I must say it's a really, really touching video, and I really, really didn't expect this. Last year during my birthday, it was during circuit breaker, so I spent it in lockdown at home. I feel a bit guilty, this birthday I had I have had so many nice surprises. Yesterday, my friends specially made a Wang Talu cake for me, like a birthday cake that was specially designed, and there's just so much effort that was put into it. And my birthday was just yesterday, but like I started celebrating like a week earlier, and I didn't ask for any of these. Like, my friends just asked me out, treat me to dinners, and like arrange for cakes and stuff like that. And it has all just been really, really, really nice. And you know, I turned 37 and I look back on my life and I just feel very, very lucky lah to have such good friends, and you know, like who really care for me and go out their way to make me happy, including this video, which is like such a big surprise, you know, like because the birthday is over ma, so I already thought that the wave and wave and wave of like niceness that I got from my friends have been like over and done with lah. And then this one is just like, oh my god, it's like jump on top of it, you know. So it's just like I'm just like feeling very emotional about it. Yeah, so I'm very touched by the video. So if you are one of the people in the video, I just want to say that, you know, like thanks very much for being a good friend, and I appreciate you guys a lot lah. And yeah, and I'm just very happy lah. Yeah, it's a good birthday. Yo, you are part of the people. Yes, so let me just add that in, okay? Yes. And I just got scolded by my production team for not including them, because they are the ones who came out with this, right? So to all my staff, I love you guys too. Thank you very much for this surprise. And to one of my good friends who is conspicuously missing in the video, Hui Wen. So she is not being interviewed here because she's one of those people getting the video done, and I can hear her in the background asking questions to my other friends lah. So yeah, okay, end of the video. Remember to subscribe, like, and click that little bell icon. Do any of you listen to that? I doubt it, right? Anyway, yeah, so do that. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.